Okay, so the binary system uses numbers 0 and 1 to represent any number within the computer. So for example, let's say we have the number 16. Okay, this number 16 in binary is going to be represented as 10000. Okay, this particular digit represents 2 to the power 0. This one represents 2 to the power 1, this represents 2 to the power 2, this is 2 to the power 3, and this is 2 to the power 4. Okay, so this number, what it means is 2 to the power 4 plus 0 multiplied by 2 to the power 3 plus 0 multiplied by 2 to the power 2 plus 0 multiplied by 2 to the power 1 plus 0, which is equal to 16. Okay, so this particular number in binary is the binary representation of the number 16 in the decimal representation. Likewise, in the decimal representation also, the way we represent a decimal number is really this is going to be 10 to the power 1 and this represents 10 to the power 0. So 16 really is 1 multiplied by 10 to the power 1 plus 6 multiplied by 10 to the power 0. So that is 10 plus 6, 16. Okay. This is how essentially the numbers, the integer numbers are going to be represented if we are only interested in 0 and positive integer numbers. If we are interested in negative integer numbers also, in addition to this these 5 numbers, we will require one more digit to represent whether it's a positive number or a negative number. And that particular digit is what is known as a sign bit. Okay, bit stands for a binary digit, and the sign bit represents that it determines whether the sign of that particular number is positive or negative. Okay, so in general, what we are going to have in a computer representation is that an integer number will be represented by a finite number of bits. The first bit represents the sign bit and the remaining bits represent the actual number. The first bit over here will be a sign bit, okay, and the remaining 7 bits are going to represent a number. Okay, so let us first talk about a positive number. For a positive number, the sign bit is going to be 0, okay, and then remaining bits are going to represent the rest of the number. The smallest non-negative number that you can represent is of course going to be 0, and the 0 is going to be equal to 0000000. Okay, so we have 8 zeros representing the number 0. Okay, the highest positive number that we will be able to represent in this binary system is going to be 0, which stands for the sign bit representing a positive number, followed by 7 ones. Okay, now what the number does this represent? This represents 2 to the power 0 plus 1 plus 2 to the power 1 plus 1 and so on up to 2 to the power 6 plus 1. Right, to the power 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the maximum number this is going to represent is 2 to the power 0 plus 2 to the power 1 plus 2 to the power 2 up to 2 to the power 6, which we know can be written as 2 to the power 7 minus 1. So the maximum integer that can be represented using this particular notation is 2 to the power 7 minus 1, which turns out to be 127. So 127 is the largest number that can be represented using an 8-bit integer representation. Okay. Likewise, the smallest number that can be represented is going to be actually minus 128. And I won't go into the details of how the negative numbers are represented. Let's just stick to the fact that for the negative numbers in the sign bit we will have the number as 1, and for the positive numbers the sign bit we will have the number 0.